Hello everyone, welcome back to supplychainway.com. This is a part 2 of the topic, what is supply chain? So if you have not yet seen the part 1 of this video, what is supply chain, you can look for the link to that video in the description of this video. So let's get started with the part 2 on what is supply chain. So what we have seen in the earlier video is I have said a supply chain story to you, and basis that I have explained you what is a supply chain model. So this is a supply chain model what we have discussed about. So in this video what we are going to do is spend more time in understanding who are all the key stakeholders and what are all those specific activities they are doing part of supply chain. So let's start with the demand planning. If you see the story, what happens here, the mother notes down all the favorite dishes of her son for lunch and other details. So how it happens, the mother is just sitting with her son and then asking, hey son, what are the things you need, etc. But in reality, if you're having hundreds and thousands of customers, it is practically impossible to meet with those thousands of customers and ask them what they want. So that is where demand planning is done, leveraging your history of your past sales, what you have sold in the past. That is number one. And using the market research, that is where the demand planning interacts with the current happenings in the market very closely to estimate what my sales would be. The third thing, there will be a lot of usage in terms of forecasting tools to arrive at the demand forecast. So the demand forecast is the output from the demand planning, which if you relate to the story, is a list of what the son needs for lunch, is typically the demand forecast. So once the demand forecast is given, supply planning is to knock down that requirement into the raw materials. Again, in the example we talked about, the mother plans for the ingredients to make the lunch. Similar way here, to make that final product, what are all the raw material it is needed. So the ingredient is on the story. The right term in supply chain is all the raw material which is needed to match demand, what has been forecasted. Okay, so that is the output of supply planning, to tell what are all the raw material I need. So once you have that, the purchase order is sent to the supplier. So what the purchase order means, the purchase order tells the supplier, these are all the raw materials needed by when at the manufacturing facility. This is what the purchase order will read. That is sent to the supplier. What production order does is, it will tell the exact date by which the finished product should be ready. So that will trigger basically the start of production. It will read by when your finished product should be ready. So once these two orders are released, that is the purchase order and the production order, are released to the supplier as well as the manufacturer respectively, the supplier then bases the purchase order, ships those raw materials to the manufacturer based on the dates given on the purchase order. As I've told you, purchase order will read when those products are required at the manufacturing facility. Basis that, the supplier will be shipping the raw material to the manufacturer. Now the raw materials are at the manufacturing facility. Now, basis the production order, the manufacturer will start to convert the raw material into finished product. The right term to use is FG, which is finished goods. So manufacturing facility is the place where the raw materials are converted into the finished product in the form and shape which is required by the customer. So in the example, the ingredients are converted into lunch, which is as required by the son. In a supply chain way of telling, the raw materials are converted into finished goods by the manufacturer. Okay, so that is how the relevance comes on. So now the finished goods are ready. The retailer gives the sales order to the manufacturer, and basis the sales order, the products are then sent to the retailer. That is called the distribution. So what the sales order will read? The sales order will exactly tell when the finished product is required at the place of the retailer. Basis that, the manufacturer will be shipping the product to the retailer. If you see that, there is again, I have mentioned one more sales order, which is from the customer to the retailer. So what customer is giving is also a sales order, and basis that, the retailer will then ship it to the customer. In both these scenarios, that is customer, between customer and retailer to manufacturer, there is a sale is happening, and wherever there is a sale happening, you use the term as sales order. So there are three different orders we have seen, and you have to be very, very clear on this: purchase order, production order, sales order. I will explain one more time. Purchase order will trigger the supplier to ship raw materials to the manufacturer to reach the manufacturer at the date said in the purchase order. A production order will trigger production, that is conversion of the raw material to the finished product, basis the targeted date, that is the date by which the finished goods has to be ready at the manufacturing facility. Okay, so that is a production order. And third one is a sales order. A sales order will trigger the shipment of the final product to the retailer based on the date required by the retailer. This completes the entire supply chain model. So now you know who are all the key stakeholders involved. They are the supplier, manufacturer, retailer, and customer. And activities done by each of the stakeholders. What is the job of supplier? Receive the purchase order, ship the raw material as per the purchase order to the manufacturer. What the manufacturer's job? His activity is based on the production order, convert the raw material into the finished product. And manufacturer also, what he does is receive the sales order from the retailer, basis that ship the product to the retailer. Distribution takes off movement of product from the manufacturer to the retailer and also from the retailer to the customer. So whenever the product is on wheels or any mode of transportation, that comes under distribution. Basically, movement of product right from manufacturer till it reaches customer, we call that as a distribution. What is the job of a retailer? Place orders to manufacturer, receive and stock goods at the retailing outlets, and receive sales order from the customer or understand the procurement from the customer, and then ship the product to the customer or have a place where customer comes and picks the product from the retailer. So this explains the different activities happening within the supply chain model. The last one, I'm going to now explain what is the definition. If you see all the video series, the definition comes the last, because that would be little theoretical. The what is more important is your understanding of the concept. So I will be always telling the definition in my own words. It's derived from the concepts in the way I have explained to you. So what is supply chain? The definition goes like this. Supply chain is defined as a network of people, process, system, information, and infra involved in planning, supply of raw material, conversion of raw material to finished goods, and distribution of finished goods to the customer. This is how you define a supply chain. I'm sure this is now clear to you, and you got answers for the three questions we talked about during the start of the video part one. If you have any clarifications, you can write back to me on the comment section in the video. Thank you so much. I will meet you with another video from supplychainway.com. Thank you.